to Ingomar. Welcome back to Ingomar Middle School for annual 6th and later this evening, our 7th and 8th grade band concert under the direction of Mr. Fasani. My name's Dave DeRamo. I do traffic here at Ingomar. I also play principal during the day. No, in all seriousness, tonight is a celebration of our students. Obviously, it's been well over 720-some days total since we've had our last in-person concert at Ingomar, and in reality, in many schools across America. So this is a special night for our students. Good, yes, give it up for them. They deserve that. I think we've been to a lot of basketball games and other things on courts and whatnot, and it's about time that the students that are just as skilled in the area of the arts and on the stage have the same opportunity to celebrate in their accomplishments and achievements. So good, give them another round of applause. And thank you to you, the parents, and the families for supporting not only the school, but your students. These are obviously challenging times that we continue to navigate through, and we don't bat a thousand. We make mistakes, but I can assure you that every decision that we make is at the center of doing what we believe is best for children, so thank you. I don't want to take up any more time. Don't ever give me a microphone. At this time, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Pisani that would like to say a few words. Thank you also to Mr. Zerbach in the back tonight. Enjoy yourselves. Relax.
Thank you, Mr. DeRamo. Wow, is it great to have an audience. It's been too long. We are very pleased to be able to play for you this evening. You are looking at sixth grade band, and they have worked very hard to prepare their program for you. I'm very, very proud of them. And as I just told them in our warm-up tune-up room, I feel like they have made a very significant progress in the last 2 to 3 weeks. Not that they were progressing any slower before that, but there just seemed to be something that clicked in with them in the last 2 or 3 weeks. We hope you're going to enjoy the songs that we have prepared for you. We're going to open up. I think it's only fitting to open up with a patriotic piece for you, as Tuesday marked 80 years of the anniversary of Pearl Harbor. And I want to make a special salute to our veterans. We are deeply grateful for you and your service to our country and for those that paid the ultimate sacrifice. We are going to open up with this called March a Doodle Dandy, and eventually you will hear a little bit of Yankee Doodle in here. Thank you. want to make mention to you at least a couple thank yous. I know they're in the program, but I want to recognize our art department and the students' art that is displayed out in our foyer. Our art teachers do a wonderful job, and so do the students, providing their displays out here during concert time so that all the parents can see what the students are doing. I have colleagues here that I rely on and love working with them. Mrs. Davis is the chorus teacher. Ms. Bragels is also a chorus teacher coming over here part-time. Mrs. Donato, they are wonderful people to work alongside. They've helped me out, along with the student teacher, Ms. Heffel. I want to make a special thank you to Mr. Zerbach and his technical assistants, providing us an opportunity to record this and make it available to you in the next coming days. I also want to make a thank you to Mr. DeRamo and Dr. Harding. Wonderful administrators, very supportive of everything that goes on in this building. We're very fortunate to have both of them here, and I love coming to work knowing that they're going to be here. Let me continue on with our second selection. Hanukkah is a time that people celebrate. It's also known as the Festival of Lights. They really like this piece. It gives many different sections an opportunity to play the melody. You're going to hear our low brass really negotiate a pretty challenging melody on the Hanukkah song. Usually I invite sixth grade parents and families to stay to hear the seventh and eighth grade, but because of accommodations we've made enabling a lot of people to come here, I gotta maybe save a few more things now that I would save for later. First of all, I want to thank you folks for everything you've done. They've been trying times and keeping them playing. I emphasize practicing to them. I model that with them. I'm constantly trying to improve myself as a player, and I emphasize that and I share that with them, that it takes daily practice in order to get the skills necessary to control the instrument so that the instrument doesn't control you. Keep them practicing. They don't have to do a tremendous amount, but daily practice of 10 or 15 minutes will make a world of difference. If they want to play more, let them play more. Encourage them to play more. I have to thank Mr. Lazier and Mr. Krause for the job that they do in the elementary, because without that, I'm going to be starting from the very beginning of everything. And I really appreciate the work they continue to do in the elementary. Students, I'm going to tell you again, I'm very proud of you. Extremely proud of you. And I want to point out to you, probably the last time you heard them play, they were playing Hot Cross Buns. And I pointed that out to them as well. That was 2 years ago. And if you've been listening, they have a very nice controlled sound. They really sound good as a band. And I told them, I can't wait to hear what you're going to do in the spring, because the progress you've made up to this point has been really, really good. So without anything further to say, I have to thank the most important person, and that's my wife. And she supports me more than you can possibly imagine. When I have a good day and when I have a bad day, and it's nice being married to a non-musician because I get that perspective. But she helps me in so many ways, and I know she's here tonight somewhere, but I do see you, dear. Thank you. She is a secretary over at Peebles Elementary, and she kind of got the short end of the deal with the pandemic, because we both sat on each end of the dining room, and she had to look at me all day long. But I thank her for everything that she does. This last piece we've saved is the most challenging. It is called Kings from the East. It is based on We Three Kings. And what makes it challenging is they change from 4-4 to 3-4 time. And that can be a little unnerving, especially when you've only done one concert. But they have really done a great job with this. There was a point in the beginning I thought, well, I don't know, maybe this wasn't the right one. But boy, they buckled down, and you're going to hear a great version of Kings from the East.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming this evening. I hope everybody has a wonderful holiday season, and we'll see you in the spring.
Good evening, everyone.
Wow, Mr. Zirkle. Welcome back to Eaglemore Middle School for our first in-person concert for over a couple of years. Yeah, give them a round of applause, Mr. Zirkle. We've had a lot of action in the gyms and on the fields. It's about time for students that can showcase their talents on the stage, and then you let us have that opportunity. You've sacrificed the most, and we appreciate all your efforts and patience with the world at this time. Please give the students, it's about them tonight, a round of applause. My name is Dave Durango. I'm responsible for traffic here at Eaglemore. I'm also a principal. Things have changed in quite some time. Under the direction of Mr. Cassandra, it is my privilege to welcome all parents and families tonight to celebrate our annual band concert. I know Mr. Cassandra is excited to be back. Over 720 some days we counted since the last in-person concert, not just at Eaglemore, but across schools across the country. So thank you for your cooperation and support. These have been challenging times, especially for schools. Obviously, you know every decision that we make, we try to keep the students at the forefront of all the decision-making, what's best for their interests. We always don't bat 1,000. We do make decisions, and sometimes we get
got to make better decisions. So we appreciate your support through these times. And if there's anything that I can do to be a service to you or your family as we continue to navigate these waters together, please feel free to reach out. We're always available. We're always willing to do whatever we need to do that supports them, because that's why we're here. At this time, I would like to thank Mr. Zerbach and Mr. Brady Turner, our alumni, former Ingemar, who is now at NAI, for helping out tonight with technical assistance. I would like you to sit back, relax, enjoy the music that we have performed tonight. And without any further ado, it's my pleasure to bring on the stage Mr. Pisani. Mr. Pisani.
Good evening, everyone. It's been too long since I've seen some of you, and it's been too long since I've met some of you. We are very pleased to be able to present this concert for you. It's been a long time. Before we get started, I want to thank our art department for the wonderful work that is displayed in our foyer. Take a minute to look at what they're doing, and the students who have their artwork displayed. I want to thank Mr. Duramo and Dr. Harding, our administrators here. It is a joy to come to work with these two gentlemen because they support everything so very well. And I can't really thank them enough. They helped us navigate through these hard times. When he says that we are doing everything in the best interest of kids, you can believe that, because I witness that every day on a daily basis. I want to thank Mr. Zerbach as well and my former student, Braden Turner, back there. We have a really nice program, I believe, in store for you. They've worked very hard, and they have been incredibly resilient in playing their instruments. I've been doing this now, it's my 31st year. Nobody ever told me in college that I was going to have to teach through the computer. But in some way, in some fashion, we have managed to keep quite a few of our skills going, and I think you're in quite a shock for students only playing as little as they have played in the last 2 years. They have really worked hard, and I say something to them about playing softer or doing something different, and it's happening immediately. That is a true joy for a music teacher. So without further delay, one of their favorite songs, Hanukkah Holiday, you're going to hear them change tempos a few times, and you're going to hear the melody get bounced around from section to section. Thank you. teaching in their section, and that is Kenny Kong on oboe, first chair, Lake Hoffer, first chair on tenor sax, and Jonathan on trumpet, first chair. So a round of applause for that. Actually. At this time, I'd like to have the jazz ensemble behind me stand and be recognized. These are all members of the jazz ensemble. We are currently rehearsing once a week after school on Mondays, and you'll be hearing from them in the spring, and there'll be some other opportunities for them to perform. But we've gotten off to a great start. They're already learning to improvise, and they're already digging into the swing style that we're studying at this point. Some of you are looking on stage, probably that first number you're going, I think he's lost his mind. The tubas are up front. What are they doing there? Normally the tubas are in the back in a band. But I have two young ladies here, and during their sixth grade year, they both teamed up with very good friends and wanted to learn to play tuba. And they decided that they wanted to do a little bit of their main instrument, plus do a little bit of tuba. And instead of putting them in the back, just kind of adapt a little bit for this next number. It's called Hark the Herald Tuba Sing because it's built around the tuba section. So we thought, they're already up here. We might as well let them play for me here because we bring them up as soloists anyhow. So this is going to feature Lydia Seuss on tuba and Hayden Robertson on tuba. I have to say, as a director, it's kind of nice hearing that much tuba from where I'm standing. The curtain doesn't capture any of it. I get it all, and I like that, actually. So we hope you're going to enjoy this. Again, the melody gets thrown around a little bit. We change tempos. This is probably, is it safe to say this is your favorite song? Is it? That's what they said in rehearsal, okay. Thank you.
is a portion of my program where I make the pitch about the gift-giving season. And I try to do this every year. With the holidays coming around, you might be looking for some special thing, maybe with a music theme to it. And there are a lot of different things which you gotta be careful. While they play very well, there's music out there that you can pick that's gonna be frustrating and over their head. And the book I'm gonna show you, I do not have any association with them, I just came across this. But our lesson book is by a company or a publisher. Well, it's a company called Essential Elements. That's the book that they publish. And this one says movie favorites. It will come with a CD so that they can play along with it their favorite movies. You can look to see what the titles are. But they make a favorites in patriotic, in film, in holiday, Christmas, concert, Broadway, and I think the newest one is the Beatles. So if you're watching the new documentary Get Back, and you're introducing them, the Beatles would be really great for them to play along with. Maybe in the stocking, a box of reeds, or maybe a new mouthpiece or ligature. I can help you with that if you email. Music stand, or maybe private lessons, or maybe an upgrade in an instrument. Maybe it's one that's a little bit better. Maybe you want to go the whole nine yards with an instrument that's top of the line. But if you have questions about that, just email me, and I'll be more than happy to guide you in the right direction. There's quite a few things out there that are not really worth the money. If you have a chance to upgrade maybe to an intermediate line instrument instead of a student model, that's always a good decision. There's quite a difference in the way they play. I have numerous professional instruments, and I have a student line, and believe me, the intermediate and professional lines play incredibly better than a student line. And if music's going to be something that's part of their future from this point on, it's a good investment. The next song. The other night, I don't know how many of you were watching The Lighting of the Tree from the Rockefeller Center. My wife and I try to catch it every year. And just by chance, an artist comes on of one of the songs that we're doing and didn't realize that he was going to be on there. And I kind of figured if he's alive, he's up there in age. And Jose Feliciano comes on and does his classic tune, Feliz Navidad. And just by chance, we're going to play that for you now. We hope you enjoy this. They like playing this one. Thank you.
concert always seems shorter as it is if you've ever been to one of our spring concerts. But it really seems short when you only have one band on the concert. But nonetheless, I'm really proud of this group. Now, I don't know that there's many teachers that would like to have 70 kids at one time, what I like to say, with weapons in their hands, kind of, at the end of the day. But I do, and I look forward to working with these young people. They have really responded well in rehearsals. They're great. They're actually great. I look forward to them. Let me thank them, because they're doing a lot of hard work, and I am really so proud of them. Thank you, students, for what you've been doing this year. I look forward to what's coming. Parents, thank you for your part at home, encouraging them to practice. Ask them, did you practice? I'd love to hear you play. They're getting to that age now where you can recognize everything that they're doing. I don't know that it was always that way when they first started. You probably said, close the door. And hopefully you're saying, open the door. We'd like to hear you play a little bit. So thank you for encouraging them. Our custodial staff has done a marvelous job around here. I also want to thank my colleagues, Mrs. Davis, Ms. Grable, and also Mrs. Donato, three wonderful people that I work with, and also the choir student teacher. They helped me a lot with setup. I eat lunch with them every day, and we talk music or we talk what's going on in the world. They're just wonderful people. It's great to be able to get along with people you work with and enjoy their company. Mr. Zerbach, again, thank you. Mr. Leisure and Mr. Krause, it's not easy starting students, and I'm sure it's been difficult for them over the past 2 years, but we can't do this at the middle school without dedicated people in the elementary. And last but certainly not least, my wife, who really helps me out in so many ways. She's a secretary at Peebles Elementary. And during the pandemic, as I said earlier, she kind of got the short end of the deal during the pandemic, because we sat across each other at the dining room table. She had to look at me all day, and I feel bad about that. But her support and her love and her guidance from a different perspective, someone who loves music but doesn't play an instrument, and having that perspective really helps me out a lot. So thank you, my dear, for everything you're doing for me. We're going to close our program with a patriotic piece, and I always do a patriotic piece with each band. I think it's important for the students in their learning and also understanding the importance of our veterans and what they have provided for us and continue to provide for us. I think it's especially fitting with the anniversary of Pearl Harbor on Tuesday, and I just think that patriotic music needs to be introduced to these young people and to learn the value of what we have here in this country. We may not agree on everything, but you know, I still believe there's a lot of compassion in the world, and I hope it even gets better than what we're seeing sometimes. And hopefully that, you know, if we don't understand it as well, maybe our younger people will understand it even better, or maybe we can teach them to understand that. Thank you very much for being here this evening. We've all gone through quite a spell these last 2 years, and hopefully, you know, we get back here in the spring. We're gonna have the doors open for everybody, and it's gonna be one giant concert. I want to wish you all a very happy holiday season, and enjoy Two Marches from America. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Have a safe trip home, and we'll see you in the spring.